Hi, BrenTech here, where tech is made simple. I posted a video earlier this month, around about the 5th of August 2021, that Microsoft Edge was going to be getting a new super duper secure mode security feature in the Edge browser. And at the time of posting that video, the feature was available in Edge Canary, dev and beta channels. Now the latest is that this feature has been updated, and basically what the super duper secure mode does is it disables the just-in-time JavaScript interpreter in Edge. Now just-in-time is called JIT, or JIT for short, and Microsoft says this is responsible for a large number of browser vulnerabilities in the Edge browser, and they say that it's most of the exploits are due to JIT in the V8 JavaScript engine, which I have posted in that previous video, and I will leave a link down below to my first video on this topic if you are interested. Now, Edge switched to the Blink Chromium engine with the rollout and release of the Edge Chromium browser, which basically Microsoft says gives the browser, you know, a better performance like Chrome, and that's thanks to the V8 JavaScript engine. But the only problem with the V8 engine, as I've mentioned in previous videos, is that it gets exploited quite a bit in the Chromium platform due to the exploits that can be run in that V8 engine. Now Microsoft wants to turn off the JIT feature in Edge, and they want to replace it now in this test phase with security features that are called ACG and CET. Now the new feature in the Microsoft Edge Canary version of the browser, which I have opened, and as always is that pre-release version of Edge used for testing and experimenting. The new feature is called SAYA, or it's spelled S-A-Y-A. I don't know if I'm getting the pronunciation right, but I will just call it SAYA. And SAYA now is a flag that you need to enable to get the new setting to turn on the ACG and CET new security features in the Microsoft Edge Canary web browser. Now, as always, to do this, to enable the flag, we just head up to our address bar and we enter edge:// flags. Now, first of all, you need to make sure that you have the super duper secure mode flag enabled, else this will not work. And here it is, super duper secure mode. And I did post, show you how to do this in my previous video. And then what we need to do now is we need to enter SAYA, and there's the flag, enable SAYA. Now at the moment there's not too much information available on what this is actually about, and so obviously this is still very early days and there's no actual information regarding this flag, but what it does for the time being is it does enable a new toggle switch in the settings menu, which I will show you now. And then you just go from default to enabled, restart Edge Canary to apply that flag. And if we head over now to our settings, privacy search and services, and we scroll down to security, you will see now that at the bottom here, there is enable security mitigations for a more secure browser experience. And the description here is enabling this will disable the JIT just-in-time compiler and enable new security mitigations such as ACG and CET to provide a more secure browsing experience, as I just mentioned previously. But the only thing here is you may experience slightly slower browser performance as a result. So basically in this new setting with the super duper secure mode with the toggle switch, when you toggle this on now, you get a better security, but according to Microsoft in this early test phase, you are going to be getting slightly slower browser performance as a result. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this toggled on. It's actually toggled off by default. I'm going to leave this toggled on and just to obviously monitor this so I can report back in due course on how this actual new feature is performing. So I just wanted to let you know that the super duper secure mode has now been updated with its own toggle switch to enable the ACG and CET security features to replace and disable the JIT compiler that was there previously. So I hope you found this video useful. Once again, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.